Here we have a little bit of edge. It's been gapped and gapped and gapped. Instead of being layered, again, it's another poor management of an edge row. You might just be able to see where they've tried to plant up. Me personally, I cannot see the point of trying to plant something and allow it. It will not be allowed to grow. No light, no nutrients. Removed the fence, as you probably see with the struddle. Now this is why planting, to me, is no good whatsoever. You need to plant these, you need to clean up or clean off either side. These have been in 4 years nearly and they're stood. When we've laid this one, we'll let the light in, we'll wear this clump, these few trees over them, this year they should really take off. Also on this edge you can see remains of some old style hedgelaying. That stake, there's a stake there, that will probably have been done what they call in the Yorkshire style. Thin stakes. Now here is the proof that this was actually laid on what we call a Yorkshire style with a rail. That's the stake and behind it is a thin rail. We're laid very low, no higher than 3 foot. You can see where that is, it's gone through that, through that, through that. We've also got some evidence there. That's not a fencing rail, that is another piece of rail. And we've also got this is an old practice. This is what you have to be careful of. Even with your billup, in fact it's more dangerous with a billup, it can bounce back on you. That's why I always wear my chainsaw helmet with the visor and the peak, which is the anti-kickback for the chainsaw. This hedge now, this piece of hedge is going to be laid into this. I've taken the guards off. Take the guards off the new plant, or so-called new plant, but with a large gap. I'm going to show you how to do something that a lot of people disagree with. I'm going to dead edge this. Like I've said before, the estate does not want the fence. So what we'll do, that first pleat, that one, just behind that piece of fence, I will lay that the full length on the floor to meet that pleat. If there is another one, which I think there will be, the smaller one, and that's the one with the wiring, I'll also lay that low. If you noticed before, there's a piece of brush which I hadn't put in the brush pile. I will then, after laying that pleat, cleaning most of the side branches off, I will place that in position to what we call dead edge. I personally think this is what they did back in the day. Other people don't. Some farms in Leicester still left the gap and fenced it and then planted. What will happen with this bleach I've laid on the floor, it will send up some new growth. And then with the leaf litter over the years, the bleach will send out roots. Because an hawthorn or any tree, the new shoots that come out, if it touches the floor, it turns to a root. If it doesn't touch the floor or the soil, it'll end up being a branch. So I'll get on with this job and show you stage by stage. This section I'm going to lay with the chainsaw. Show you how we clean up and lay with the chainsaw. Double brush. We've come to a larger one, and if you look at it, there's two. On one of my videos, I videoed a lady trying to lay one a bit smaller than this, but the same shape. So what we have to do is thin it. So we'll take one of those off. We try and leave the straightest one. Some of your professionals are not like the way I did that eel, but to me it wasn't too bad. There's an overhanging branch. I like to cut him off. It does let more light into the edge. It's looking dead, so it could drop into the edge, and if it's on a public right of way, I definitely like to do them, because as the world is today, they could probably say, why didn't you do it? But I mainly do it for the light, and I'm using an extendable pole. Sometimes I do use rope harness. That's if I've got a mate with me. But you can just see what I'm going to do with this pole that extends to 6.3 metres. as you can see. I've done two cuts I don't like. But if the landowner had asked me to remove the branch altogether, the price would go up considerably. But actually, the old tree wants reshaping, so I suppose that can be left to the estate workers. But we've now got light and no interference. It also helps, as in a PC world, you need to take these branches out of the top. It helps you, it stops tangling, and it stops you losing your pleach.
Well, here we are, this is a job I've taken on. What a wonderful edge. They've had the flail in, but not enough. This road, half an hour ago, was very quiet. And at the other side of the road, as you can see, a new housing estate. So I don't know what I will find in here. But hey-o, it's true what they say. The older you get, the dafter you get.